हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ यू ऑल आर? होपिंग दैट यू ऑल आर वेरी फाइन. लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट आवर टुडेज क्लास. इन टुडेज क्लास आई विल टीच यू दैट व्हाट इज फ्लो चार्ट. थिंग्स आर गोइंग टू बी फ्लो दैट आई विल टीच यू इन दिस पर्टिकुलर क्लास. But before that, please keep in your mind that you have to keep yourself very safe, because situation is pandemic and pandemic situation becoming worse day by day. So keep yourself very safe. You all are the future of our country. So keep yourself very safe and sound. Second thing, if no work outside, then please don't go outside. It is my request as well as order also, because if you go outside, God never knows that what will happen. So keep yourself safe and your family safe also. When there is very need, then tell your parents to do anything. Don't go you. And to make yourself mentally very clean and very safe and sound, do the practices whatever I had taught you in my first video of the starting of this July month. Keep yourself safe better. Let us start today's class, and the class is flow chart. A flowchart is pictorial representation of the steps or an algorithm used to solve a particular problem. The process of drawing a flowchart is a programming problem. Just as picture is worth a sound 1,000 words, similarly a flowchart provides a much better way of solving problem than writing a lot of descriptive text. In algorithm, we are writing steps to solve any problem. But in flowchart, what we have to do? Simply, we should have to do, we have to make some figures. And by that figures, we have to explain our working. A flowchart uses different symbols to represent different types of instructions, which are connected to each other with the help of flow lines. Now let us understand first of all these symbols. These are the symbols in front of you all. They are working. Their name is also written in front of you. The first one is a oval. It is an oval. It is used for start or stop. That means whenever you will see this in any flowchart, it is basically used for starting of flowchart, and when it is used at the last, it is used as for stopping. It is used in the beginning and ending of the flowchart. This is the purpose of this. The next one is parallelogram. Parallelogram, it is used for as a input or output box. It is used for accepting inputs or giving output of the program. Next one is rectangle. This is a processing box. It is used for writing the processing instructions and doing calculations. Next one is a diamond feature figure. Diamond figure is known for decision or condition box. It is used for checking or applying any condition in the program. Suppose you are having any condition, that means if A is greater than B, then there is condition is there. A is greater than B, then two situation will come. If A is greater than B, A is greater. If not, then B is greater. That means condition arises. In this situation, this diamond box will be used. Now flow lines. This is very important. because it will decide that how the flow chart is moving and in which direction it is moving. Flow lines show the directions in which the control of the program is moving. These arrows are used to connect the various geometrical symbols in a flowchart. And the last one are connectors. There are two types of connectors. The first one is on page and next one is off page. These are used to connect one part of the flowchart to another. Let us understand these symbols with some example. Before going on example, let us know features of a flowchart. What are the features? A flowchart should have only one start and one stop symbol. Yes, there is only one start and one stop symbol. Means, suppose if we start, we take a part in a race competition, then there will be one starting point and there is one ending point. There is no two starting and two ending point. So keep in mind, if we took part in any race, there is also one starting and one stopping point. In the same way, in flowchart also there is one start and stop symbol. The general direction of flow in any flowchart should be from top to bottom or from left to right. Yes, keep in mind, in the most cases or in many cases, or we can say in all the cases, always we move like this from T to B, that means top to bottom, or left to right, L to R. This is the proper situation. Occupies more than one page, then off page connectors should be used to direct the flow of information. Okay, if it is of more than one page, in that case you have to connect it with off page connectors. Now let us understand it with this example, and example is of process of making tea. How we will make a cup of tea? First of all, there is oval, that is start, that means now we are ready to make any thing, and here we have to make what? A cup of tea. First of all, you have to take inputs. Are what? Here, take a pan, water, sugar, tea leaves and milk. These are the inputs you have to take for making any tea. Then after that, processing, because there is rectangle box. First, what? Put pan on the gas burner and pour water into it. First process. Second process, turn on the gas. Yes. Third process, put some tea leaves when water boils. Fourth process, put some sugar and add milk. Fifth process, after processing, take off the pan. Now the process is completed. Output time came. Sieve it in a cup and serve the hot tea. After serving, your work is over. Now people have to drink it and your process is stopped. Take inputs, then do all the process. After processing, then give the output, and after giving output, your work will be finished. Now next, one more thing. Calculate the sum, difference and product of two numbers. It is a small calculator, we can say, where we have to find out the sum, difference, product. First of all, start it, then input two numbers, because without two numbers you cannot do the sum, cannot do difference, cannot do the product. Then after taking input, in first process sum equals to a plus b, print sum. Then after that, difference equals to A minus B, print difference. Product equals to A into B, print product. This is the steps required to do this. In this case, maybe there is one problem arise, like in difference. In difference A minus B, if A is greater and B is less, then it is okay. If A is less and B is greater, then result will come in negative. Okay. One more example given in your book, find the greatest of two numbers. This is a tricky one and this has to be very clear by you all. See, we required two inputs, two inputs. Here you see, read A and B. A and B, these are two inputs. Okay, now first of all we have to check it, that is A equals to B or not. If A equals to B, you see there is one condition is given, is A equals to B or not. If yes, then this one will print, both numbers are equal and your program will end over here. But suppose if it is wrong, then it will go at no side. In no side, it will check again one condition, that A is greater than B or not. If A is greater than B, then yes portion will execute, and if it is wrong, then no portion will execute, and after that stop will come. So keep in mind, if you have to find the greatest of two numbers, again I am explaining, first of all you have required two inputs. Here two inputs taken, A and B, and A and B, first of all you have to check that is A equals to B or not. If A equals to B, then this one will execute and situation will end over here. And if it is wrong, then in that condition this will execute, A greater than B. If A greater than B, come. So always keep in mind, if I am checking any number is greater than B or a number is greater than or less than, in that situation three condition will arise. Number will equal, number will greater, or number will small. These three situation we have to make, always keep in mind. So this is the explanation of this example. Hope you all understood it. So just in your book also there are some examples given, not examples, I'm talking about the activity section. You go through the activity section, there is some question is given, like draw a flow chart in Microsoft Word for buying stationery from the market, draw a flow chart in Microsoft Word for the steps required to play music stored in a CD. These all are present on page number 52. Then draw a flow chart in Microsoft Word to accept two numbers. If the first number is greater than the second number, print their sum, otherwise print their product. So these things you have to do in your classwork copy. Page number 52, 53, activity section you have to do in your copy. This is your home assignment. Till then, goodbye. Take care.